For a long period of time, the so-called dancing bears were used by the Roma community in Bulgaria to perform tricks in public. But after many complaints from animal rights activists concerned about the well-being of the bears, a countrywide ban on dancing bears was imposed. In 2000, the Dancing Bears Park was founded in order to provide a safe home for the animals. Here, they're being taken care of by a special team of animal caretakers. First, a few facts. In 1993, the Bulgarian government put a ban on the practice of bear dancing. However, there were still more than 20 dancing bears active after the ban. This is why, in 2000, the Brigitte Bardot and the Four Paws Foundation funded and created the Dancing Bears Park. Thanks to a renovation in 2003, the whole area now consists of 7 separate sectors, which cover 120,000 square meters. In 2007, the final 3 bears joined the park, which is now home of 24 dancing bears. Yet, convincing their former owners to let go of the bears wasn't an easy job.
So all the owners of the dancing bears were Romas.
Ah, Romas.
Mm-hmm. And there's definitely some NGOs that are defending their rights. It's okay, yeah, mm-hmm. Nevertheless. But if we're going to do this way, to confiscate the animal, this means that we're going to the court. If we're going to the court, there will be a huge process of fighting each other. And the idea of Four Paws is not to bring some dividing into the society and putting some problems against the society. Our aim is to educate the society and to help the animals. And that's why we come to the solution that we are going to support the owners with a sum of money so they can start another business.
But you basically still had to buy the bear off the people.
So you can say buy it. I prefer to say that we compensate the owners. Yeah, although that there was a law.
The so-called training of the bears started from the moment they were cubs.
They had to break the bear, the will of the bear. So this is done by torturing the bear. I heard stories that they crucified the cubs on the ground. So the idea is that the one who will own this bear will be the who make a connection. And they made it, this connection in a very cruel way. Also, there are some rumors that they make the small cubs to dance on an iron hot plate by playing music, and they think that if they do it enough times and they heard one the same music when they are on this iron hot plate, this will become like an instinct, and when they heard the music they will start to do the same. Mm-hmm. I really hope that they never did this, because this is useless. The bears do not recognize the music, first thing, they do not dance on the music. And secondly, the bears are performing so-called stereotyping behavior, which is exactly this thing. They are moving from one paw to another paw, waving the head. And this is what is called dancing.
It didn't take long before we got to see what Dimitri was talking about.
This is the typical stereotyping behavior that the bears are performing, which in the past somebody called it dancing, a dance. So this is not totally a dance, but if you put it away with a little bit of music, maybe someone can recognize that the bear is dancing.
So for how long can the bear keep on doing this? Because it's been going on for a while.
Yeah, it depends. She can do it from 5 minutes to 8 hours, as I said.
8 hours even.
Yeah.
So, I assume all those bears have like mental damage?
So yes, all they have mental damage. This is because of the chaining of the bear and putting to a life which they were. The most thing that it's really unfortunate is that these bears could never be released into the wildness again, because they don't have the developed instincts and they don't have the knowledge how to survive there. The problem comes even with other bears which had been taken very, very young from the mother. So a bear, if it's taken from the mother, they cannot live with the mother, they do not develop enough.
And that is why the park has a no mating policy.
The problem with the breeding is coming from the situation, as I explained before, the cub is staying with the mother for 2 years. And if we breed a bear here, the cubs will not get real knowledge. And then we cannot release them into the wildness, and they have to stay here. And this is not the idea, that we do not make more captive animals. We would like the animals to live their normal life, and if some captive animals need help, we will support them.
Because of the non-mating policy, Dimitri states that the park will switch their focus on helping circuses improve the condition their bears live in. So cases like the following will never occur again.
And yeah, here is a bear. I think this is not anymore in our park, but she's in the tram. And this is how they brought around. This is in Sofia, this is Gosho, and you can see the owner, how big he is. And here's the stick, which is keeping always the bear. Whenever it's happening, he will keep the bear away, and this is in the market in Sofia. Normally, all these things had been done on the coast of the sea, because there's more foreign tourists, so there will be more money. But not anymore. Sorry.